represents gentleness, but also strength, domesticity, freedom. And so I like the way these things went together. And also I was studying Tang Dynasty poetry, where you have these, you know, these pictograms, these words that lie side by side. And because we're human beings, we want to make some sort of meaning out of them. And also, when I came up with the idea for this, I was at an artist residency in Germany, and literally my writing desk looked out a window onto these three horses. Do you guys have trouble hearing me?
No.
Yeah. Can I just do it micless?
Oh,
okay, thanks. And so, yeah, so it's a very literal image, and that's where I wrote this song, at the end, like 20 years ago. And it was the first time as an adult, like I'm an immigrant to Canada, but the first time as an adult being outside my culture, being outside my language, being, you know, surrounded by people and hearing their stories, all these diasporas from all over the world. And these horses just started to represent all of this longing and displacement and loneliness, you know. So.
And we have the horse hanging on the rearview mirror as
That's something. Well, you know, I got a little horsey, which is like a little stuffed animal that I had, but that was something that was added very late into the process, actually. Yeah.
Now, Rosie's journey from Canada to Iran was fascinating, but then equally fascinating to me was the journey that Stick Girl took to Window Horses. And I was wondering if you could talk about that a little bit.
Right. So I didn't do any animation on this film, but I actually did study animation. And in my second year at Emily Carr, I was hit and run over by a couple cars. And I couldn't walk, I couldn't really do anything, and people wanted me to drop out of school and just go sit on a beach somewhere and recover. And all I wanted to do was to learn how to be an animator. That's all, like, I would be so depressed if I couldn't do that. And I used to wheel myself down, you know, I was in a wheelchair at the time, and I had maybe 2 hours in me every day, and I would just do something, and all I could do was this little stick, you know? So Stick Girl really represented all the strength I had at that point. And we've made tons of films together over the last 30 years. We've done some webisodes, and we have like a iPhone app. And this is the first time she's ever had a name, the first time she's ever had someone else be her voice, Sandra Oh. And it's the first time she's been half Persian. You know, it's her first feature film. It's a big deal for Stick Girl. But she, you know,